अस्सलाम वालेकुम। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस वर्ड्सवर्थ थ्योरी ऑफ पोएट्री एंड पोएटिक डिक्शन एंड कॉलरिजिस क्रिटिसिज्म ऑफ इट। व्हेन वी लुक एट द जेनेसिस ऑफ वर्ड्सवर्थ थ्योरीज, वी कम टू नो दैट वर्ड्सवर्थ एंड कॉलरिज केम टुगेदर अर्ली इन लाइफ। इट वॉज इन 1796 दैट दे वर फ्रीक्वेंटली टुगेदर एंड आउट ऑफ देयर म्यूचुअल डिस्कशन अरोज वेरियस थियरीज which Wordsworth embodied in his preface to the lyrical ballads and which he tried to put into practice in his poems. Coleridge claimed credit for these theories and said they were half the child of his brain, but later on his views underwent a change. He no longer agreed with Wordsworth's theories and so criticized them in chapter 17 and 18 of the Biographia Literaria. In his preface to the lyrical ballads, Wordsworth made three important statements, all of which have been objects of Coleridge's censure. First of all, Wordsworth writes that he chose low and rustic life because in that condition the essential passions of the heart find a better soil in which they can attain their maturity, are less under restraint, and speak a plainer and more emphatic language. Because in that condition of life, our elementary feelings coexist in a state of greater simplicity and consequently may be more accurately contemplated and more forcibly communicated. Because the manners of rural life germinate from these elementary feelings and from the necessary character of rural occupations are more easily comprehended and are more durable. And lastly, because in that condition, the passions of men are incorporated with the beautiful and permanent forms of nature. As regards the choice of rustic themes and characters, Coleridge points out first that not all Wordsworth's characters are chosen from low or rustic life. Characters in the poems like Ruth, Michael, the brothers, are not low and rustic in the usual acceptance of these words. Secondly, their language and sentiments do not necessarily arise from their abode or occupation. They are attributable to causes which would result in similar sentiments and language if these characters were living in a different place and carrying on different occupations. These causes are primarily two: independence, which raises a man above servility, and a frugal life and industrious domestic life. Number two, a solid religious education, which makes a man well versed in the Bible and other holy books. The admirable qualities we notice in the language and sentiments of Wordsworth's characters result from these two causes and not from their rural life and occupation or their contemplation of nature. Even if they lived in the city away from nature, they would have similar sentiments and similar language if they were subject to the two causes mentioned by Wordsworth. In the opinion of Coleridge, a man will not be benefited from a life in rural solitudes unless he has natural sensibility and suitable education. In the absence of these advantages, in rural conditions, the mind hardens and a man grows selfish, sensual, gross, and hard-hearted. Coleridge agrees with Aristotle's view that the characters of poetry must be universal and typical, and they must represent some particular class as well as general human nature.